My name is Zach O’Farrill. I'm the Director of Education Programs at the Afro Latin Jazz Alliance, and I'm the Director of the Fat Afro Latin Jazz Cats. Over the years, this band has changed a lot. We started out, I think we had 8 students, not counting my brother and myself. The level was pretty varied. The level's still super varied, but now we have enough for 3 different ensembles, a big band, and 2 small groups, and we can have everyone in a group depending on what level they're at.
What sets this band apart is the fact that it challenges me in a different genre of music. So Afro Latin jazz is not usually a genre that I have in my school or in other music programs. And so through this, it challenges me, it opens up my taste in music.
When I first joined Fat Cat, I had 0 experience playing Latin jazz, playing any type of Latin music on the drums or percussion or anything. First couple rehearsals, I was just blown away by the music, how fun and joyous the music and the whole vibe was.
The diversity of the music, like the Latin mixed with jazz, I think a lot of bands are focused around one genre, but we do a lot of different types of music.
I like that the band, it's really like a community, and it's really great musicians too, and the level is really high.
The Cuba trip has just been such an amazing opportunity, such an amazing experience.
Zach really takes the time to work with us individually and the sections individually, and we've got great instructors, Zach and Jim.
I've been doing several rehearsals so far, and I already feel welcome in the band, and I already feel like I'm learning and growing every time we rehearse.
In my mind, being a teacher and being a student really aren't that different. It's really about the journey of education, right? It's not about, you know, at the end of this time I've learned all this. It's about the process of learning.
Fat really has instilled in me that music is something that brings people together, not that divides us. It's something that transcends basically any other divisions that we experience. So realizing how powerful and restorative music can be is definitely the biggest takeaway I've gotten from my years at Fat Cat.
I didn't see you there.
Thanks for stopping by.
My name is Zach O’Farrill, and I'm the Director of Education Programs at the Afro Latin Jazz Alliance. What you just saw was a video we had created to promote our Fat Afro Latin Jazz Cats, our pre-professional group of training ensembles for young musicians in the New York area. We're actually going to see a whole concert they performed in June 2019, just a few days before our second trip to Cuba, which unfortunately this year we couldn't do because of the COVID-19 crisis. Actually, we're holding auditions very soon. We're holding auditions this Sunday, October 4th, and next Sunday, October 11th. If October 4th sounds a little soon, don't worry. We've reserved October 4th mostly for returning students, so that new students have more time to prepare and work out those jitters. We'll actually be holding the program this year at Shapeshifter Lab instead of at Fat Cat, where there is much more space to spread out. And they are very well equipped for all the health and safety measures recommended by the CDC and the New York State Department of Health. In fact, every meeting we've had with them has left us more reassured that they are prepared to do this program as safely as possible. So, if you are a young musician hungry to play, or you know a young musician hungry to play, and you're interested in more information, please send me an email. Now, without much further ado, the Fat Afro Latin Jazz Cats at the WNYC Greene Space, June 2019.
Thank you. song was Obsession, and the next song we have is Fera de Mangayo. So for the band, this is Charlie on guitar. Miles on drums. Zach on percussion. Hannah on bass. And Arturo on piano. And I'm Katya on the piano.
Thank you. We, you know, I want to tell you a story really quickly. You know, the thing about this music is that those first experiences playing with other people are super important, man. And you can't begin to understand. I did a conference at the Smithsonian on whether Americans have lost the ability to innovate. And there were famous people and authors and all kinds of people, blah, blah, blah. But what they walked away with was the idea that we have lost the ability to innovate because we're so afraid to fail. Well, there's such a premium on winning and moving forward and achieving that young people are scared. And imagine an environment where you can come into proximity to your peers and not be afraid to fail. Imagine an environment where you can come into proximity with people your age group and not be afraid. And this is what makes great musicians. This is what makes great musicians, the ability to fly into the infinite without a safety net. And I'm telling you, this is the most experience, the most important experience these young people can have. And so it's a real privilege. We walk into these situations and give young folks an opportunity to be fearless. And I'm telling you, that's an experience that we want to be able to give with them for the rest of their lives. And they will carry them for the rest of their lives. This is the Jim Seeley group, I believe. Is Jim Seeley ready? That's all I wanted to tell you. That's all I wanted to tell you was not to be afraid. And let's not, in our lives, as adults, as people who are in charge of these young folks, not be afraid to fail them, to give them every opportunity that we can. Let's not fail these young people, okay? Thank you. Thank you.
basically, a lot of the tunes were tunes that I brought in because I knew what I wanted them to work on. And so if they didn't, I knew what it was about. So it's been an amazing journey this year, watching these young folks come along and grow and become better musicians. And that's really the reason we do it. So we've got one more for you. This is another one that I wrote called Fat Cat Blues. So stay on F minor till we come in. One.
Thank you. I'm sorry, David.
David, Max, Hannah, Mercer.
Nice job, guys. Nice job.
How's it going?
Good.
My name is Zach O’Farrill. Obviously, the Afro Latin Jazz Alliance is a family affair. I Arturo is my father, and I direct the Fat Afro Latin Jazz Cats. I kind of help organize all three ensembles, and I direct the big band. And it's probably every week. It's probably one of the things I most consistently look forward to is working with these incredibly young musicians who are here of their own volition, who come to Fat Cat of their own volition every Sunday to rehearse, practice, and grow a lot. And I find that we all grow through the process. On Thursday, which is the day after tomorrow, we're going to Cuba for the second time with these students. You should probably hold your applause till after we've gotten back, but I appreciate the belief. But yeah, we're going to Cuba. We're going to do a lot of really amazing things. We're going to perform down there. We're going to meet with we're going to have a master class and performance with Los Muñequitos de Matanzas, which is one of the premier folkloric groups in Cuba doing rumba. We're going to meet with other students down there. We're going to learn about Afro-Cuban culture. We're even going to go to the beach. It's going to be a really incredible trip. We had a great time last year. This time's going to be even better. And I think we're ready for more music now. We're going to hear right now from our education coordinator, Richard Miller, who's a fantastic guitarist, and one of our newer Fat Cats, Mimi Block, who is a great violinist and great singer.
Bem que ele disse, a male torice, bobagem e ilusão. Eu prefiro viver tosa sem nenhum som do laneto do meu violão. Toda disse, eu bem que ele disse, olha essa brilhante que me meter. Agora, amor, toda disse, meu bem, como é que nós vamos fazer? Toda disse, eu bem que ele disse, a male torice, bobagem e ilusão. Eu prefiro viver tão sozinho o som do lamento do meu violão. Toda disse eu bem que ele disse, olha essa brilhante que me limitei. Agora, amor, toda disse meu bem, como é que nós vamos fazer? Um belo dia você me surgiu, eu quis fugir, mas você insistiu. Alguma coisa penetrava me avisando, até parece que estava me aviando. Bem que não queria me casar contigo, bem que não queria esperar disponível. Toda disse, agora você quem que me disse, como é que nós vamos fazer? Ba da 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 ba ba da 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 ba da da ba da ba da ba da da ba ba da 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 ba da da ba da 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 ba da 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 ba da 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 ba da 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 ba da ba da 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 ba ba da da ba da ba ba da ba ba da 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 ba da ba dim di ba di da dim da ba da ni da ba ba di ba da ba ba da da ba da ni da ba. Thank you.
We're going to do a little more music for you, but before we do, there's people that we need to acknowledge. Carlotta Perez Applebaum, where are you? She's incredible doing this incredible job of organizing all this. Michelle, where are you? I know Michelle's here. There you are. Michelle Gee right there. Leonor, come on, wake up. Stand up so we can love you. One of our great, great board members. Jim Wacht, we've heard his name. He's been our staunchest advocate in education, and we love him so, so very much. We want to also acknowledge Eddie Castell, our board chair, and Mark Landis, who's on our board. They're not here this evening, but they send their love. We also want to take a minute and acknowledge, I don't know how many of you know the story, some of you don't, some of you. When I first started this, I walked into the roughest school in Canarsie and said, I want to teach. I walked into Fan Fox and said, give me some operating money. I didn't know what I was getting into. But I had a friend, Abraham Narvaez, who looked at me and said, what do you need, son? He literally said, son. I said, well, just some money. And he gave us the seed money to create all of this, the orchestra, the education work, the preservation work, and all across for many years. We remember Abraham with great, great love, and we want to thank Liz for being here this evening. Liz Narvaez. We also will take a minute and acknowledge the Greene Space. Greene Space gave me an incredible residency. This one of the biggest thrills of my career was having a residency here that I called Musical Acts of Deviancy. We had a program called Friends and Foes at the Piano, all kinds of crazy stuff. These people are nuts. They're letting us here doing these things. These people are great. How about a big, huge round of applause for the Greene Space? It's just the four of us? No, Adam? I thought you were going to kick Adam's butt. Where's Adam? No. Let me tell you the story of Jim Seeley, first of all. Jim Seeley taught my son, Adam, how to play the trumpet, refused to take a penny. And now Adam's going to, you know, they're going to have a little duel, see who is.
Is that what this is?
This is all about that. You thought you were just going, no. You thought you were just coming to a fundraiser. Well, this is way more. This is a duel to the death. Is Adam, that's it. Okay. Where he goes. Come on, Adam. He's coming. Okay, here we go.
Thank you.
Hannah, Zach, Adam, Jim. I think you're okay, Jim. I think you're still safe, bro. I'm not sure, though. We're going to continue. We're going to bring the big band up, and we just have a little while. We want to thank... Do you have more words? Or okay. We want to thank everyone, especially I want to recognize this person who has just risen to the top of so many things. He's just become as great an educator as I've ever known, and I have to acknowledge him because Zach O’Farrill is doing an incredible job of leading, inspiring, educating, and changing all of us one at a time. Thank you, Zach. Here's Richard Miller again.
I second that about Zach. It's such a pleasure to work with Zach. And I want to reckon, well, doesn't this feel like a family here? Yeah, right? And I wanna recognize two of our newest board members. And so Carlota and Michelle, can you please come up here? Yeah, so Carlota and Michelle, thank you. They have come in and they've been shaking things up, making things happen. And they're just starting. So thank you, you too. Yeah. And now we have a performance by the big band. And this is all everybody you've seen, most of them are going to Cuba with us. And I want to thank especially the parents and donors who made that happen, because not all of them can afford to go to Cuba, but we made sure that they all go to Cuba, and that's because of your generosity that we could do that. So thank you.
Yeah, we're gonna take this opportunity to thank everybody who donated for our trip to Cuba, but it's not too late to keep donating. So if you have your checkbook with you, or if you have cash, we take credit card, we take whatever currency, and we will appreciate it because this trip is life-changing for our students. And we are trying, you know, the administration, the Trump administration has just stopped these trips. And we were able to get the tickets before they were forbidden to buy the tickets. So we had to advance a lot of funds for the students to go. It is important that everybody has this experience, and it's a great opportunity for us. So if you have any donation to make today, please, we will appreciate it. Thank you.
I get a microphone again. I don't like to pull out music for them to play that I don't. I would never bring in like an easily arranged high school jazz band chart for them. I pull out music from the actual library of the Afro Latin Jazz Orchestra, and we get it sounding good. We've done a lot of great music this year, and we're really excited to show you what we've been working on. We're gonna start with a classic mambo from the Machito book called Sambia. I love doing these old charts because they're not playing. If they were to find an original recording of this tune, it'd be really similar. Maybe the chart's been updated a little bit, but it hasn't been simplified for them. It's been, they're playing the same music that was played 50 years ago, and I find it very moving because it, when they're playing these charts, what they're doing is they're actually connecting themselves with the very tradition that this music came from. They're playing the same music that the masters of this music played 60, 70 years ago, and they form this strong connection, and it gives these charts a whole new meaning to be played today, and it gives these young musicians an incredible context for what this music comes from and what it's really about. So we're gonna play Sambia.
Thank you.
like I said before, Fat Cats is a family affair. And to that end, I went to LaGuardia High School, and a couple months ago, I went to a performance at LaGuardia High School of the songwriting class, the New Music Ensemble, and I happened to see a song that really blew me away by this fantastic young singer-songwriter right here, who happens to be the older sister of our team Balero, Adam Cabo. This is Noga Cabo. And she's going to be singing a beautiful arrangement by Jason Lindner of a song by the great Chilean singer-songwriter Violeta Parra. This is called Volver a los 17.
See.
Noga Cabo, everybody. We're gonna play our last song, which is, let me step back a second. When my father first founded the Afro Latin Jazz Orchestra, it was pretty hip. I know he's my dad. I'm not supposed to like what he does, but I have to admit, he was pretty prescient and ahead of the curve when he decided to call it the Afro Latin Jazz Orchestra, because what he was doing by using the word Afro Latin instead of Afro Cuban, which is just what Latin jazz was thought to be up until that point, by saying Afro Latin, he left the door open to a whole continent's worth of music that has been influenced by and has integrated with jazz. Right? It's not just Cuba and music that comes from Cuba. It's not just salsa. There's literally an entire continent. There's Colombia, there's Peru, there's Brazil, there's Argentina, there's Nicaragua. There's tons of countries that each have their own music. And by using the word Afro-Latin, he left a lot of possibilities open and has actually wound up being a huge influence to musicians all over the continent. And that really influenced me as a young teenager playing music. And so I really wanted to share that with these guys. This next piece we're going to play is based on an Afro-Peruvian rhythm called a festejo, which is a really groovy rhythm. But if you're not used to it, you'll get these parts and have no idea what's going on rhythmically. When the band first started playing this piece, they pulled out their slide rulers and was like, wait, how many beats, does this fitting into 12/8? Does this work? They had never seen anything like this before. They learned it, and if a bunch of adults can learn it, then I figured I can coax a bunch of teenagers into learning it too. So that's what we're doing now. We're going to play a piece by Gabriel Alegría called El Sur. But before I do, I want to introduce these incredible young musicians to you guys. I'm not going to give any last names because I'll definitely put my foot in my mouth if I do. Saxophones, Ben, Madison, Luke, Flora, Philip, our trombone section, Rebecca, Mimi, Troy. That's not a lot of applause. Come on. You guys are playing their asses off. Our trumpet section, Isaac, Andrew, Sam, Jim. Our rhythm section, Lars, Adam, David, John, Felix, and Omer. I also got to give a special thank you to Jim and Bam Bam as my co-conspirators with this, and Richard for being so helpful with so much stuff. My dad for founding it all, everyone who works at ALJA, and you guys for being here. We're going to play El Sordo for you.
the Fat Afro Latin Jazz Cats at the WNYC Greene Space in June 2019, directed by myself, Jim Seeley, and my good friend Bam Bam Rodriguez, who couldn't be there that day, but was there in spirit. Remember, if you're a young musician who wants to audition, or you know a young musician who might want to audition, that email address is... Now we have something special for you. We have the students of the Susan E. Wagner High School in Staten Island, directed by the inspiring Paul Korn, doing a collaboration of sorts with the musicians of the Afro Latin Jazz Orchestra. This was the culminating project of a residency we've had at Susan E. Wagner High School for several years now, where musicians from the Afro Latin Jazz Orchestra go to the school to give private lessons, combo rehearsals, and big band sectionals in preparation for a concert where the students share the bill with the ALJA. That's our acronym for the Afro Latin Jazz Orchestra. Because of the COVID-19 crisis this year, we had to cut the in-person residency short, but band director Paul Korn was very, very quick in making sure that the students still got their time with our musicians remotely. And this is the end result. What does it mean to give the gift of music to a young person? Well, it can enrich their lives. It can make them better human beings. It can actually end up being enabling them to follow their dream as a profession. I can speak to that because Larry Bustamante, who was a protege of Paul Korn's and a graduate of Susan E. Wagner High School, is my baritone saxophone player in my professional orchestra, the Afro Latin Jazz Orchestra. So the partnership between ALJA, the Afro Latin Jazz Alliance Academy, and the orchestra and the young people that come out of this program is incredibly important. And so I just want to thank Susan Wagner and Afro Latin Jazz Alliance for continuing this partnership and seeing so many young people's lives changed.
Hello, my name is Paul Korn, and I'm the assistant principal of the Performing and Visual Arts at Susan Wagner High School, as well as the director of the jazz band. I'd like to take a moment to thank Arturo O’Farrill and the members of the Afro Latin Jazz Orchestra for their continued work with the students in the Wagner Jazz Band. For the past 3 years, this has been a highlight for our ensemble, where the students get to immerse themselves in the Afro Latin jazz style while learning side by side with true masters of the music, who not only share their artistry and their knowledge, but their true love and passion for making music. I'd like to also commend the students and the members of the orchestra for continuing this learning as the COVID crisis hit and all instruction went to the online platform. We are so proud of all that they've accomplished together, and we look forward to continuing this work for years to come. Thank you so much, and enjoy the performance.
My name is Zach O'Farrill. I'm the Director of Education Programs at the Afro Latin Jazz Alliance, and I'd like to talk to you about what we're doing in education at ALJA this year. What you just saw was the culminating project of our residency at Susan E. Wagner High School in Staten Island, featuring the students of their jazz band collaborating with the incredible musicians of the Afro Latin Jazz Orchestra. What started out as an in-person program had to switch to an online format when the COVID-19 crisis hit, and their director, Paul Korn, is really to be applauded for his decisive action in making sure that his students continue the incredible opportunity of learning from the musicians in our orchestra. This is really representative of what we do in education at ALJA, which is put young musicians, musically curious people, and the musically averse together with incredible artists from the ALJA family. In addition to our residency at Susan E. Wagner, this year, despite the circumstances, we are committed to continuing residencies in a few of our most select schools that have had the most successful programs in the past, in the Bronx, Queens, and Brooklyn. In addition to that, we are also beginning a series of 10-week online courses for adult musicians, adults of all ages. In topics ranging from jazz, harmony, and improvisation to Cuban percussion and Brazilian percussion. I'm particularly excited to announce that just earlier this week, we got the confirmation that we'll be able to continue our incredible Fat Afro Latin Jazz Cats program, or the Fat Cats, as we call them, are pre-professional youth training ensembles that draw from kids all over the city and have them come together weekly to learn music from incredible musicians, play repertoire from the incredible library of the Afro Latin Jazz Orchestra. We'll be doing the program at Shapeshifter Lab in Brooklyn this year, where students will have enough space to be socially distant, and we'll also be doing health screenings before each rehearsal to make sure that everyone stays healthy and safe during these very bizarre times. If you are, or if you know, any young musicians who are hungry for the opportunity to play, need to meet peers that they can continue playing with, and are just bored silly of learning in front of a computer screen, please reach out to us. Please reach out to me. My email is zofarrell@afrolatinjazz.org, and you can click the link below to have more information on a flyer. Thanks, and have a good evening. Thank you.